Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to episode number 3 of Success Within. And today we have a really special guest and, you know, an interesting entrepreneur. You don't want to miss this.
Hey guys, my name is Vik Prakash and I am a startup entrepreneur here in Las Vegas. And I'm more than happy to help Rod in his venture with Success Within. I'm glad to be here and looking forward to getting you guys all value for this interview.
Great, Vic. It's great to have you here, man.
Thank you, man. Appreciate
it. It's great. So why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do as an entrepreneur and the projects that you're involved in?
Okay, so right now, like I said, I'm a startup entrepreneur, and what we're doing is we're building a augmented reality platform for home goods. And so our main mission is to make the home and where you buy furniture and other home goods as seamless as possible. So instead of going to IKEA, driving there, checking out all the furniture, you would have a simple screen, take your phone, and you can try out thousands of products right there in your living room. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you can just like try it out right there, right in the moment, and see if you like it, how it looks, if it fits or not, how you can combine with other stuff at the same time, right?
Of course, yeah. So exactly, you can basically, on our platform, you can try out a chair, sofa, make a whole living room set, and present it to your girlfriend, your spouse, whoever the real decision maker is.
Yeah, right.
Get her okay and buy right there from our platform.
Yeah, man, that's good. And you know, the reason that I love this is because it's like playing The Sims in the real life. Man, I love that game. I could spend hours and hours every day during summer, you know, just playing and, you know, building the house and, you know, buying stuff and furniture.
It makes the whole experience more playful. Like you said, The Sims. And that's what we really want to do, is get that playful environment going again. The home should be a playful environment. Right now, the home is not. You have to go through all of these different steps to even look at furniture, right? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You have to go to the store, you have to drag your kids and your spouse there.
Yeah.
You gotta keep everyone behaving right. And not only that, but you have these salespeople that just bombard you, like say, hey, do you want to buy this? Do you want to buy this?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not ready for a decision.
Yeah.
I don't even know.
Yeah, exactly. I think the most important thing here, or what I like the most, is that you can actually see how would it look, you know, like actually see it, not just imagining. Because maybe you can imagine like it's gonna look this way, but at the end it turns out that it's a completely other thing.
Absolutely,
right? Because it happened to me like I don't know, like 4 months ago, or I don't even remember when I moved in to my place. I bought like a little shelf and I was expecting to be bigger. So you know, I got it, and you have to assemble it and all this stuff. So it was like super short.
Really?
You know, I thought it was going to be like, you know, like maybe this high.
Yeah.
Well, it's like almost to the floor. You know, so it wasn't what I was expecting. Mm-hmm. So I think by developing this type of, would it be like a software or?
Yeah, it's going to be an application on your mobile. And the way it works is the same exact reason, right? So people have the problem with the visualization, especially for such a big object, and you're gonna be able to this is your home, so you're gonna see this bookshelf, like you said, every single day.
Yeah.
And you're reminded by like, I got a bad deal, or you know, I got a good deal. So we want to make it as fun as possible, take out all of those problems right now of visualization, saving you time, saving you money. And it's gonna be an application. We're still in development phase. And we just partnered up with a couple of retailers here in Las Vegas. I can't get into details about who, just because some investors and things like that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, man, that's great. And you mentioned here a keyword for me, which is visualization. So why don't you tell us, what do you think, or for you, it's like the most important thing to be successful in life? I mean, for me, I said it's a key word, visualization, because for me it's one of the most important things. But for you, what would you say it's one of the most important things?
Yeah, so that's an interesting question. The most important thing for me is knowing exactly what you want. A lot of people go throughout life and are pulled from external things, right? So you can see the news, you can see like Kanye's like wearing a new thing, or you get pulled, right?
Yeah.
All these different things. It has to be internal, right? You have to have a mission statement or something that drives you every day.
Mm-hmm.
For me, it's just pure helping people, right? So I want to leave the world a better place than I found it by impacting as many people as I can.
Yeah.
That's what drives me, man. And I think that's what you need. You need a mission statement. Everyone needs that mission statement. I think what a critical skill that people should have been taught in school was to write down a mission statement and see it every day.
Yeah, absolutely.
And be like, hey, this is what I'm about.
Yeah, yeah. Trying to teach people how to figure out what they really want, right? Just not going through, you know, the how things are right now, that you just have to, like the standard process, you know, that, yeah, you have to figure out what do you want to study, you know, like the degree, so you can get a job. But people don't really know, you know, like actually what are they studying, what are they going to do for a living, like the actual job, what does it take, what are they going to be doing in real life. So, you know, like I think like college doesn't really prepare you for real life. It just gives you like a bunch of knowledge about a specific thing, but doesn't really teach you how to go out there, you know, and really make a living. Or, yeah.
Yeah, that's an interesting thing. I have a very love-hate relationship with college. I see college as a great place to meet people and be social, but like Rod said here, it's not a great place where it teaches you some critical life skills. And I think the most important one is taking chances. Because in that school environment, you're taught by a professor to do X, Y, and Z. And if you deviate from X, Y, and Z, you're going to fail. And that's not what life is about, right? You have to be outside. You have to think outside the box, and you have to take the chances, especially if you're an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
Right? Me and you would not be sitting here if we didn't take any chances.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. Risks are part of this journey for every entrepreneur. And I don't know, guys, if you noticed, this is the third episode. And so far, there's a pattern I would like to you know, bring out. And that's when I ask this question, that what it takes in life, or what's something that drives the entrepreneurs. So far, the pattern is, at some point, everyone wants to change somebody else's life. Like,
yeah.
Make someone else's life better.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not... you know, like being an entrepreneur is not doing something like selfish, just like doing something that you like, but it's something that you like, that you love, that you enjoy, to make someone else's life better, you know, to make the world a better place, to make something, you know, it's just not about you.
Yeah.
Right.
That's a critical thing. If you come into the entrepreneurial world and just think about yourself, I guarantee you, friends, that you will not have a successful career, because this is a value-based business, right? So you have to be able to deliver more value than you are taking in, let's say dollars or relationships, right? So let's say this program is $100, right? Rodrigo has to provide more than $100 worth of value for you to think that this program is $100. By doing so, he's not doing it for him, right? So by putting out something that has value to others,
mm-hmm.
he's improving himself. You're improving yourself by putting it out there, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
it's like saying, like, what do I need to know and learn, and, you know, like learn how to put out there to make someone else's life better.
Yeah.
So in order to do that, first I have to be better.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
I can, you know, improve someone else's life. Right?
Yeah. It's I'll tell you, man, when I started this journey, I guarantee you I didn't know half things. Not even half, like.
Yeah, I would tell like a 1/10 or, yeah.
It was a crazy journey because I never thought I would be sitting where I am, on the position that I that I'm sitting in, because my skills were so limited. But I embraced that instead of thinking of that as an obstacle, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I surrounded myself with people who knew things, right? I like to consider myself as, or try to be the dumbest person in a room. I like to surround myself with smart people so that you can ask questions. And my granddad used to always say, show me the five people, show me your friends that you hang out with, and I'll show you who you are.
Yeah.
And I didn't understand it for the longest time, but now that time has gone by and I think, okay, who do I interact with?
Mm-hmm.
Are they improving my life?
Yeah, exactly.
Constantly ask yourself that.
Yeah, my mom used to say to me the same thing, you know, show me your friends and I'll tell you who you are.
Yeah.
And I would be like, oh yeah, mom, just, you know, get off my back. I know what I'm doing. You know, it's my life. You know, these are my friends. Uh-huh. And you don't know them and, you know, whatever. But as you, you know, grow older and you go through all these type of things, you really take in consideration and you start to understand what's the meaning of that thing. You know, like there's also a quote that says that you are the average of the five people you surround yourself with.
Yeah.
Right? So you really want to pay attention to who are those five people. Because, you know, if these guys are people with no goals, procrastinators, negative people, just people that's gonna bring you down all the time, well, guess where you're gonna be.
Yeah, I call them poisonous people. So the people that have those abilities that Rod just described, those are poisonous people. And if there's only one thing you guys take away from this whole interview, is cut out at least one poisonous person. That doesn't mean you have to completely stop talking to them, because for some of us, it's family, right? And that's the trickiest part.
Yeah.
Family, just distance yourself. Because what I've seen is that sometimes these poisonous people keep you down because they've not had the ambition or the drive to try something for themselves.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's kryptonite for all of the entrepreneurs, right? If you surround yourself with negative people and poisonous people, you're going to drink that Kool-Aid.
And end up the same. Yep. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And just remember that just because they can't do something doesn't mean that you can't.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Your mind is a very powerful thing, right? Even if you have little and you think you have a lot, then you have a lot. But if you have a lot and you think you have little, then you have little.
Yeah.
Your mind is... you have to put yourself in the right perspective.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something I've really, really struggled with recently, is because just priming yourself, right, for success. It's one of the critical things. People talk about the law of attraction and things, and I believe in that. You have to put out so much good to get good back.
Mm-hmm.
Call it karma, call it law of attraction, whatever you want to call it, but it's true. Those things are true.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
absolutely. And I think that's one of the toughest part for any entrepreneur, get your mindset right.
Yeah.
Because especially when you're surrounded, you know, like, I don't know, percentages, let's say, for me, I would say it's like around 92% of people that doesn't think this way. And they're always like looking at the negative side of things, or they're always seeing like there's problems everywhere and not solution, or they're not looking at as a challenge or something like that. You know, it's just like, let's call them the average people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with that until one point. But if you're not average and you're not looking for having an average life, you have to separate yourself from that type of people, right?
Yeah. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with separating yourself from the average people, right? there comes a time where you can't take it anymore. You want more in life, and so you have to surround yourself with beliefs that you can have more in life. Mm-hmm. We live in a very particular time. We live in Las Vegas. Everyone here is wealthy. We live in America, so everyone here has opportunities to become wealthy.
Mm-hmm.
No matter who's in office, no matter what political things happen, no one can stop you but you. If you have the right mindset, if you have the right perspective, you can accomplish anything. And I truly believe that we live in a world where there's limitless opportunities.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And there's, I think that's one of the excuses that I hear the most. Like, well, yeah, this guy could make it, you know, he's wealthy because of his family or because he was lucky or because, you know, just whatever excuse. And I always say, like, okay, yeah, maybe we're not all born with the same opportunities, but we all have the same opportunity to be better than we were the day before. Yeah, the day before. Yeah.
So
right.
I agree with Rod. You don't get to choose the hand you're dealt, right? If I'm dealt two aces, then my life is set. But if I'm dealt like a 2-7 offsuit, then I'm fucked, right? But you play with the hand you're dealt, right? And you can bluff and you can fake it till you make it, as long as you're trying to do better.
Mm-hmm.
But don't fake it till you make it by being an asshole. Fake it till you make it by trying to impact the people that are around you. And the way I do it is by getting involved with the community, by letting people know my true intentions of, hey, this is exactly what I want to do and this is why. I think a lot of people, a lot of entrepreneurs, a lot of, especially young ones, get into entrepreneurship for the wrong reasons, especially money. Because
yeah.
Everyone sees the opportunity, and social media has been doing this a really bad disservice to all the entrepreneurs.
Yeah,
they keep posting these lavish lifestyles. It's not always like that. It's
yeah.
a constant grind.
It's usually never. I would say like 99% of the time, it's not like that.
It's not.
Especially at the beginning.
Of course.
Yeah. Yeah, that's something that I wanted to talk about later, but I'm glad you're talking about that, because there's a lot of people that they want just, you know, like paint that scenario, right? That it's gonna be like super easy, you know, like this kind of, I've seen all type of ads, like laptop computer lifestyle and all this kind of stuff, like just work 2 hours per week and you're gonna make 10 grand per month, just doing like nothing, right? And that's, I think that's even worse, because more than just the fact that it's not true, but it makes people get disappointed and think that it's not possible.
Yeah.
You know, it's like all a fraud, that is just like more setups from people and from rich people getting richer. You know, that's one of the things people think all the time. You know, like rich people get richer while poor people get poorer, right? So I think that's one of the things now with all this, you know, technology and advertising. You know, there's a lot of people out there saying, yeah, you have to be an entrepreneur, it's going to be super easy, you know, no effort, you need to know pretty much nothing, right? And that's not the way it is. And when people try it and discovers that that's not the way, you know, it is
yeah.
in real life, they just get disappointed
and they
just just quit and go back to the same thing, and even with the worst attitude towards the successful people.
Do you have a lot of young entrepreneurs that follow you?
Mm-hmm.
All right, guys. I don't know Rodrigo's audience, but I'm gonna assume that you guys are young entrepreneurs, or even young to entrepreneurship, right? Guys, it's not easy. You have to work your fucking ass off, 18 to 19 hours a day, consistently. Not just one day in 10 days. Consistently put in the work to better yourself, right? So everyone has 24 hours on this earth. Me, Rodrigo,
yeah.
You know, Richard Branson, to the hobo on the street. We all have 24 hours. It depends on what you do with those 24 hours that will make you successful. Consistently do for those 24 hours, right? So, I forget who said this quote, but maybe somebody can help me out in the comments. They said, If you do exactly what you did today, you will be the same as you are today. I think it goes like something like that. So you have to change your attitude, you have to change your actions, and you have to change who you surround and interact with constantly so that you can better yourself.
Yeah, and especially don't be complaining about the results that you didn't get for the work that you didn't put in. Because, you know, that, you know, people are just, oh man, so I worked so hard one day out of 10 or just once a month and I didn't get any results. You know, it's just like, keep going. And sometimes you just have to, it takes even years. You know, sometimes I've been broke twice. Since I started this, I think it's been like 6 years now.
Wow.
And I've been already broke twice, you know, thinking, damn, if this doesn't work tomorrow, if I don't get this project going or this sale or whatever, I don't have anything to eat tomorrow.
Yeah.
And, you know, my mom depends on me, my family, so I have, you know, a really big load on my shoulders.
Yeah.
And it was like, man, if I don't do this, if I don't succeed with this today, like literally today, tomorrow, we have nothing to eat. It's just like the example with the rock. You remember that he says that he had $7 in his pocket and, you know, everything then changed. I was the same way. I mean, I'm not the rock yet. Thank you, man. I'm not the rock yet, but man, it's been, and the first time, you know, I was like dead broke. And the next time I was almost there, you know, because I didn't really learn about this stuff. Because it's really hard to really, you know, like learn everything you have to learn in order to be successful, right? So you have to fall again and again and again. But the point here is that you improve yourself, I think, and every time you fall forward,
yeah,
right? And you don't go as deep, you know, and as low as the last time.
Yeah. And so, Rod, 6 years ago, right, did you ever think that you would have what you have today?
No, not at all. I, you know, 6 years ago, that's, you know, one of the problems that we were talking about. I didn't even know what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
I just knew I had to be, you know, do something different, but I had no idea how was I gonna do it, how long, you know, or what was I gonna do? You know, what was, I think I didn't have any goals. Maybe I had the same goals that everyone with it starts, you know, yeah, I wanna be rich. I just want to have money, and that's it, you know. And that's and as you know, you know already, that's not a goal. It's just a vehicle for your true goals.
Yeah. So a lot of people say they want to be rich, right? And especially here in America, we see so much wealth. Man, to be honest, to be the 1% in this world, you don't need millions of dollars. You only need to make about $500,000 a year.
Mm-hmm.
Less than, actually. I think it's 400.
I think it's 350.
350?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's $350,000, right? So what is that? That's what, $37,000 every month?
Yeah.
Dude, guys, we live in the internet age. If you're passionate about anything, whether that's fitness, whether that's cars, for your girls, yoga, you can make money.
Mm-hmm.
You just need to start a following. You just need to pick up the phone, start calling people, taking actions, taking risks, and don't be regretful for any failures. Because like Rodrigo said, you're gonna fall forward rather than backwards. You have to have, I go back to attitude, because whenever you pick up the phone or whenever you talk to somebody and they say no, there's only so many no's until you get to a yes. So don't consider the no as an ending point. My early career was making cold calls and interacting with a bunch of different companies, right? So I would call like 50 companies a day, and most of them said they were not interested in the services. We were selling digital marketing, insurance, and all these different products, but most of them said they're not interested or they already have a person. But I saw each no as a pathway to a yes. And when a yes did happen, I did the math backwards and said, each one of these calls, each one of these 50 calls is actually worth about $50 over my time. So if you look at it that way, right, it's so much easier to be down on yourself. But consider entrepreneurship or business as an experiment. Look at it as a scientist, right? You're experimenting what the market wants, because you might have a great idea, but the market's gonna maybe not like it or like it. It all depends on making the market happy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, that I believe that you guys all have the opportunity to be that 1%, especially today.
Yeah, exactly. So would you say that anyone in this world could be an entrepreneur?
If you have certain qualities, and if you can cultivate those qualities, the qualities of being a risk taker, the qualities of self-belief and confidence, if you try hard and want to fail, yeah, you can be an entrepreneur. But it takes dedication, it takes hard work to become that. It mm-hmm. just doesn't happen overnight. And
yeah.
if you want an overnight success, go get a job. Go climb the corporate ladder.
Shit.
But I have a big philosophy of myself. If I'm going to work 100 hours for somebody else, I'd rather that person be me.
Exactly. Absolutely. I've said that all the time to all the people I know,
yeah.
Right? It's, man, I'm putting in the time anyways, mm-hmm. so why not doing it for me, you know, for my, and doing what I like,
yeah.
Right? Because there's something that I was really, really wrong, you know, with my mindset about. It wasn't long ago, I think 6 months ago,
okay.
You know, that I was, I went into the real estate investing
yeah.
business,
yeah, yeah.
Right? So to me, I choose to go into real estate because I thought it was like an easy and a quick way to make money, right? So I was like, yeah, that's gonna work, you know, just make money fast, good money, you know, and get to the things, now to the different goals that I had set up, only not only the money. But then talking to one of my mentors, he asked me, why did I choose real estate? And I was like, well, it's a vehicle and it's just gonna make me money fast and so I can go from A to B,
yeah.
Right? And I was like, but I think it's not necessary. I mean, I don't really like it or I'm not passionate about it, but it's going to take me from A to B. And that's what I want. And he was like, well, you can't. That's not how it works. Because if you don't really like what you're doing, it may work for a little bit, but then it's going to all crash down. And eventually, or you're just going to start doing things wrong, or you're just not going to enjoy it. And it's going to be the same that just, you know, working at a regular job, a desk job, for, you know, to me, like, being behind the desk 8 hours, 10 hours, 6 hours, I just can't. I had that option with my in the company where my mom used to work, and she was like, you can take my place. She had like a really good a position at the company. So to me, it could have been like the, you know, easiest way out. Just like, okay, she retires and I just take her place. That's it, you know, easy life, you know, 9 to 5 with all these benefits. And but I just couldn't, you know, to me, I felt like, okay, it's too easy, it's just not for me, you know. It doesn't matter the money or, you know, just whatever, I just can't do it, right? So combining those two experiences, I think if you're not passionate about what you're doing, eventually you'll fail and you're just gonna burn out and yeah. won't be as successful as you would if it's something that you really like or you enjoy doing.
And yeah, man, it's don't focus on the money. Try to become excellent or that thought leader in one thing, right? Whatever you're mm-hmm. passionate about, whatever really motivates you or whatever the end goal is, right? So when I was a kid, I was really passionate about video games. I used to game a lot. I wanted to be a pro gamer. And I looked at it this way. I had a bunch of jobs when I was growing up. I said, okay, I'm gonna do X, Y, and Z to get a console or get a new game or whatever it may be, right? So that was a wrong belief. I could have become a better gamer and done. You guys have a great platform now. I didn't have Twitch, I didn't have YouTube. There was no way for me to broadcast what I did. I wish I did. Looking back at it, I would have been YouTube famous.
Yeah, man, I would play 8, 10, 12 straight hours.
Yeah. Dude, we could have been like gaming like celebrities, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I see them a lot. I see a lot of them now. But my interest changed, and I picked augmented reality because I saw that as the future.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And to be honest, I didn't know anything about 18 months ago. Didn't know Jack.
Yeah.
And everyone starts that way. There's a complex of not knowing anything, but not knowing that you don't know anything, right? But then you slowly move towards, I believe it's unconscious incompetence is where you start. Everyone starts this way when they're learning a new skill. If you ask me, I can be like, hey, if I'm in this state, I can be like, hey, yeah, Kobe, I can be Kobe in one-on-one.
Yeah.
But who knows, right? Like, I just see him on TV. But then you go out there and you try something, and then you realize you're consciously incompetent.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Now you know that you don't know anything. Like, I know I can't shoot a basketball as well as Kobe. And then there's the competent incompetence, right? So then you're confident in your abilities, right? But you don't have the abilities yet. You're learning.
Mm-hmm.
There slowly comes a time where you're just consciously competent. You can walk into any room, whether you're a businessman or whether you're Steph Curry, and shoot a basketball from half court and be like, all right, I'm gonna drain this. I'm just gonna turn back. I'm gonna shoot it and turn around.
Yeah.
Because I know it's gonna go in. Because that guy has put in the work. No one. You have to go deep into the skill that you want. No one just starts off being...
Yeah, the best.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Even for your coaching and for your lifestyle, man, you didn't have these skills.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's something that you have to learn and go through a process. And this, you know, a learning process, and that's two things, learning and applying the knowledge. Right, that also takes me to this other thing that I wanted to ask you. Do you think it's important to have specific knowledge about what you're doing?
So with the knowledge aspect, that's what I used to thought. That was a limiting belief of mine. I said, hey, I need to get 20% knowledge before I can even start doing this. That's the wrong thing to have to do, especially if you're young. If this is for any young or young businessman or businesswoman, go out and seek help from all of these experts, because what I've realized is that the experts in the fields that you want are slowly retiring, and they want apprentices. They want to teach people. The greatest thing about success is that successful people want to teach others.
Yeah.
Right? I've gained so many mentors that I just went and asked and said, hey, I want to know about augmented reality. And I'm not an expert in this, but I know that you are, and I'll do anything to gain some of your knowledge. Do you have any insights? They said, okay, cool. That's awesome that you want to do this. Go do X, Y, and Z and come back to me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you guys even have Quora, the questions and answers form. You can ask anything, and they lay it down. Experts come to you. You know, you don't have to be, even if you're in a rural area, of let's say Mexico or United States or even internationally, right, like Brazil or anything, you can still go to these services.
Mm-hmm.
The information is there.
Yeah.
We live in the information age. You can download a book, a PDF, and read it on your laptop.
Yeah, honestly, there's no excuses. You know,
there's no excuses, man. There's another thing I don't like. Whenever I talk to a young person, they say, I'm so bored. Do you ever encounter this, Rodrigo? And people say, hey, I'm bored.
Yeah.
What do I do? I'm bored.
Yeah.
How are you bored?
I know.
Guys, you can literally look up anything you want. If you want to become the next Michael Phelps, you can look up his regimens of practice. You can look up what he ate.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to become the next, I don't know, give me some examples. You want to be the best artist, right? Calligraphy artist. You can look up tutorials from the best calligraphy artist.
Yeah. Yeah, there's everything out there. I mean, with information, and you can learn pretty much anything. And I would say 90% of the time is actually for free.
Yeah.
So it's not like you have this limit that there's, oh, well, I have to pay this amount of money. Man, 90% of the information out there is free. I mean, for the at least for the basic and maybe even intermediate stuff, it's just free.
Yeah, right? Everything. You guys live in the greatest time in human history. Do you agree, Rodrigo?
Yeah.
We live in the greatest time in human history, guys. There are so many opportunities out for everyone. Whether you are 6 years old or 62 years old. I just met a Lyft driver who has a side business of making custom blankets. She makes blankets, guys.
What?
She's successful selling blankets.
Man, that's awesome. That's
right?
Awesome.
Like, you can sell anything.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. That's actually one of the things that I teach in my coaching programs.
Yeah.
Because usually people don't know, because I would be like, well, why don't you start your own business? Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know what to do for a business. And, you know, people usually think that they have to learn something new or just do something else or, you know, whatever. But they don't realize that by applying or just like getting some inside information, they can put out there or start business with the things they know and the things they love.
Yeah.
Right. For example, one of my best friends, you know, so far, he studied something with companies administration, you know, something like that. But the truth is, he loves alcohol, right? And he's been doing bartending for 3 years in these Caribbean cruises and this type of stuff. And until now, you know, I was like, well, man, you have to start doing, you know, something serious. And, you know, if you have these goals, start, you know, taking things more seriously. And now with the coaching that I'm doing, that's the great part of this, that I'm also learning stuff every day. So I was like, well, why don't you start a business around that thing that you like, which is, you know, preparing, you know, like drinks on all that kind of stuff. Man, it's huge. You know what? With all the knowledge, because he's passionate about it. You know, he really enjoys getting people drunk, you know, at clubs or at wherever place. And that's his thing. And before I was like, well, that's not cool. You know, that's not a good business. It's not something that you would like to do, because I don't drink. Mm-hmm. So I was like with that negative mindset and that closed, you know, mindset. And then I was like, well, you know what? That's what you love, right? It could be a business. You know, there's the marketplace, right? There's a ton of businesses who sell, you know, cocktails and do parties and bars and all this kind of stuff, and he really enjoys that. So
where's your friend at right now?
He's right now at Mexico.
Okay, guys, he could be the Mexican tipsy bartender.
Yeah,
right? Like, all he needs to do is get a couple of attractive women, make a specialty drink in Spanish and target it to Mexico and all of South America, actually.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yes, it's yeah. Simple.
Yeah, it's really, really simple. And they're like maybe creating new recipes or the same recipes, but
or
improved.
Giving out a Latin
and then,
flair to like,
yeah, exactly. He loves to do that, man. He does all the thing, the throwing around, make all the show. And I'm like, well, you could also go to bars and talk to the managers and, hey, I'm selling this package. What I teach your bartenders how to do this, and you're gonna, you know, increase your revenue, blah blah blah, by improving your system with this and blah. Man, for how much you think you can sell a training program on that?
Oh.
I mean, thousands of dollars, and how many bars out there?
Oh,
right.
Absolutely.
I mean, come
guys,
on.
Guys, the bartender is key in any bar.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys are old enough to drink, but if there's not a good bartender, dude, the whole business, the whole restaurant business
goes down.
Mm-hmm. And man, that's such an easy business.
Yeah, I mean, and that's just an example that everyone can do. But usually people don't realize that they can do what they like and what they love and apply it to a business and turn it into a business. So they are not aware of those abilities of or that knowledge. So what I do on those coaching training programs is help people find out how can they apply what they love to do and what they know to put it out there as a business. And it's so easy, you know, it's really so easy, but once again, college doesn't teach you how to do that, right?
Yeah,
anywhere else.
College is great for certain people who want to be lawyers or specialized
doctors,
you know. It's terrible for business people, to be honest with you. College is a structured thing, right? The market doesn't care. You could be uneducated, and I know a lot of uneducated people have gas stations and hotels, and they don't speak a lick of English.
Yeah.
They have 20, 30 hotels, gas stations. Mm-hmm. They're making bank. Every month, they're making at least $500,000 off all these places, right? So, it's crazy, man.
Yeah.
You just have to put yourself in that position to win. And if you look right now, you're watching something in where Facebook was created by a guy who dropped out. You're probably watching.
Yeah, just not to mention Steve Jobs, Bill Gates.
Yeah.
Man, the list goes on and on.
Larry Page, you probably Googled this. Larry Page dropped out of Stanford.
Yeah. Yeah.
Guys, you don't need college, especially with the tools. If you're a self-learner.
Not in this era. You know, it's just like out there, you can learn pretty much anything through internet, right? And if you're going to pay, you know, for college and you want to do like business, I think it's better to go to training programs that really go like for business. For example, the Grant Cardone's University, that is for business, and they teach you this and you have to pay. But man, if you're going to invest, you know, money, at least you get that knowledge that you know that you need, right? Instead of just getting a bunch of general stuff that won't help for nothing.
So you always have to ask yourself whether the instructor has done what you want to do, right? So even with the training programs, I know there's a lot out there, and Grant Cardone is a good guy, but there are some shady people that do these things. But I actually like it this way, right? When I was starting out, I told myself, I only had a little bit of money, but I told myself, hey, I had about $3,000, right? I said, hey, with this $3,000, I'm going to start a business, whatever business I can. And even if it's successful or not successful, I will have had a business education by doing. That's the one thing that frustrates me, is that people don't do. People plan out their day, say I'm gonna do this and this, and they talk to a bunch of people, they're excited, and they'll spend 6-7 hours surfing the web and not learning anything, but they're not interacting with the market, they're not interacting with their potential customers.
Exactly.
You have to go out there, man.
I have, you know, again, one of my friends is like, I have this idea and I've been learning about this and that, and I think I'm almost ready, but you know, I don't know. And I'm like, man, launch first and then you optimize.
Yeah.
Right? You have to, you know, either way, you have to keep learning as you go. So the first step is actually doing, right? And from there, you can just like tweak here or there, or know actually what you need to learn more about, instead of just guessing what you should be learning and then not applying it. And then you end up doing nothing and not really knowing if it's something you know, valuable what you learn or not, or just
it's a lot of guesswork, right? So you have to go out there, man. Even if you think you need to learn, let's say, how to program, the market might already have programmers that do this on reliable. You can outsource a lot of programming and design work. You just need to position, right? So let's take his bar example. He doesn't need a programmer. You might need a couple designers to come out with a cool layout for his videos, but that's like $15.
Yeah.
He could literally get his company started with $15 in design work, about $300 for a decent camera, right? And some editing software, or if he doesn't have the editing or the hardware, you could pay another, let's say, $20-$60 to get video edited when he gets done with shooting. There you go. You have all the resources to get it done. You can start a business for under $500.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
And as soon as you start branding and start building that awareness of you, of yourself, you're gonna go places.
Yeah. I would say that it all starts happening as soon as you start failing.
Yeah, absolutely. You have to fail to succeed.
Mm-hmm. And that's what you realize of what it really takes to get things done, mm-hmm. right? So when you go through these, you know, like obstacles or challenges, what keeps you motivated? You know, like what gives you that thrive and drive to just keep going every day?
So before I get into that question, I'd like to say something about failure, right? People have this weird thing about failure. Some people. It's like a mindset thing. So even if you're successful, right? If you're trying to attain a goal, say your goal is to become a very influential person in your community, right? And you fail, you can either look at that as a failure or look at that as a success. So what I'm trying to say here is that whatever the outcome is, look internally, right? So you can consider yourself a failure or success, but it doesn't really matter what happens externally, right?
Mm-hmm.
The outcome doesn't really matter. If Rodrigo thinks he's a failure, then his mindset's gonna be, I'm a failure, I'm a failure, I'm a failure. But he's like, no, 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 I'm a successful guy. I'm success. I'm going to attain my goal. Then even if he fails at the goal, he's still successful. You guys get that? It might be a little abstract idea to think about, but that's what drives me, right? So every morning I say, hey, I'm going to do this next 24 hours. I'm going to do my best to become a better version of myself. And through that, I'm going to be one step closer to my success, my goals, right? It's very, very easy to let others define your success or failure. As entrepreneurs, we're not the same as other people. Mm-hmm. We don't want the 9-to-5. We don't attain, we're not happy with just $60,000. I haven't really talked about money, but we're trying to attain something different. So you have to be different. You have to think differently to mm-hmm. be an entrepreneur. That entrepreneurial mindset is the mindset of success, right? So every interaction you have is training your mind to either become successful or failing. You're learning constantly. So put yourself in that position of, hey, everything I do is success. Just by action is success.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, talking a little bit more about what we were saying of the people that surrounds you mm-hmm. and you hang around with, I would say a good rule of thumb to know if someone is a positive influence for you or not is to share your goals and your dreams mm-hmm. and to, you know, tell them like, okay, I wanna do this. Let's say, I want to start my company and in 5 years, I'm gonna make my first $1 million in revenue, right? And if they tell you something like, well, you're just dreaming, get a job, that's not gonna happen, or, you know, something negative, that's the people that you want to cut out.
Absolutely.
Because positive people, people with the like-minded,
ambition,
they won't ever tell you, you can't do that. They will ask you, okay, how are you gonna do it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they won't say that you can't, mm-hmm. but just gonna make you, you know, like push yourself to figure it out if it's possible or not. I mean, I would say there's no such thing as something like being realistic. I think like you can accomplish whatever until, you know, a certain point. You just can't say, okay, I'm gonna start my business tomorrow and one day I'm gonna be a millionaire. I mean, that kind of stuff, it's all obviously like not being realistic. But like setting goals, like really big goals, I think that's not being unrealistic.
No, big goals. No, guys, actually, big goals are good. Becoming something bigger is so much easier to get people to support you. If I didn't have such an ambitious goal of starting this augmented reality startup, I wouldn't have that many people around me. If I just wanted to start a simple bar, there's thousands of bars, maybe tens of thousands of bars in Las Vegas. I would never be successful in a bar. You have to think outside and think bigger than what society or the people you're around are telling you. Don't think of $1 million, think of $100 million and think of that, right? So if you shoot for the moon, right, you'll end up on the stars. So you'll end up much higher than you ever thought possible. You have to shoot for something bigger. The power of thinking big, man. You have.
Yeah.
If he hasn't recommended that book, you have to read The Power of Thinking Big.
Who's the author?
I can look it up for you, but it's Power.
Yeah, and also I think it's good, guys, that you take in consideration that it's gonna take you the same time and the same effort working on a small goal than working on a big one.
Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely,
so
yeah.
If it's gonna take the same time and effort and energy and everything on doing something small, well, rather go for the big one.
Yeah.
Right?
Do the bigger thing because your time is finite, okay?
Yeah.
We haven't talked about legacy, but I think of legacy every single day. You have to think in that terms of what your legacy is going to be. If you try to do bigger things, you'll have a bigger impact. The drop of, let's say your life is a droplet, right? If you try to do bigger things, that splash is going to be bigger. And that's what you want. You want to impact as many people as around you. The magic of thinking big is by David Schwartz. Everyone read that book, please. And then there's also another book I recommend to you guys. It's called The Obstacle is the Way by Ryan Holiday. Those two books have defined who I am. And if you want to become a self-taught person, I would recommend reading Growth Mindset or just Mindset by Carol Dweck. And also I'll forget the other one, but I'll let you know.
Yeah.
I'll put it in the comments. Man, those three books right there. So, The Art of Thinking, The Power of Thinking Big, The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz, Growth Mindset by Carol Dweck, and The Obstacle is the Way by Ryan Holiday. Those books will define who you are. If you read those books, those stories, you realize that no one starts out being perfect. There is no perfection. You have to fail to succeed, like Rodrigo said.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And I would like to throw in another book that, you know, to me, it was a life changer. You know, besides the ones that I, got me started in this, but lately I read this book about 4 months ago, I would say, and it was like a life changer. It's
okay.
Called The 5-Second Rule,
okay,
by Mel Robbins.
Okay,
it's so good. It talks about how your mind, how it takes only 5 seconds to your mind to talk you out of something.
Really?
So, for example, in the morning, just to hit the snooze button, if you just go and it takes you just 5 seconds to before you hit the snooze button. Right, so if you just go right away, stop the alarm, and get up, you just get your day going. But if you wait those 5 seconds, maybe 4, 6, you know, everyone's different. But once that time has passed, you hit the snooze button. And what happens? You go back to sleep. And then, you know, everything falls apart. And that's with everything. You know, maybe to me, you know, a clear example was a couple of months back, I ran into Jay Cutler, the bodybuilder,
okay,
here in Vegas. And to me, he's just one of my biggest idols, you
yeah
know, from bodybuilding. So I look at him, he was walking towards me, and I could have said like, hey, hi, just a picture or, you know, an autograph or whatever. but I keep thinking, what should I tell him, or should I do it or not? He was, I think yeah, maybe so, he was yeah. in the phone. Yeah. So that took me more than 5 seconds. And so I didn't tell him anything. He just walked by me, you know, just by me. And I was like, damn, what is wrong with me?
Yeah.
So that book really changed a lot of those things that you just have to, you know, act before your mind talks you out of something, you know, just do it. So it helps, you know, in the biggest way you could ever imagine.
And that's what every entrepreneur needs to do, right? They just need to take action. Everyone plans, everyone has ideas. No one takes action.
Mm-hmm.
No one. What separates you from the rest of the people is taking action. If you don't take action on your goals, then you're gonna be the same person. One of the greatest quotes, I'm gonna leave you with this, okay? Leave you guys with this, is leap and the net will appear. So that basically means that if you take action, someone or something will back you up. And that's action in a good way, right? Like if you're trying to impact the world in a better place or in a better way, somebody's gonna support you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like I said, successful people want ambitious apprentices, right? They want somebody to take that step. Nobody wants to just leave their legacy out to anybody or their knowledge out to anybody.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
You have to earn it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, Vik, thank you so much for being here.
Absolutely.
This episode 3 is going to be so good, guys. I know it's a little bit long, but it's worth watching. If you got onto this point, I'm pretty sure your life is going to change.
Yeah.
Right?
If you guys want, you guys can follow me on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
It's Vik's Yacht. So that's V-I-K-S. I'll put
the description. Right, yeah, we'll put your information in the description or the social media.
Yeah.
And
any questions, guys? We'd love to communicate with Rodrigo's audience. And looking forward to all your success stories.
Absolutely. Thank you, guys. Catch you later.
Thanks. Bye.